Welcome to the Slide Gains Tech Simplified channel, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about Microsoft Security Score and how it improves your security posture inside your organization. So let's get this thing started, and make sure to watch this video to the end. Knowledge is king. I absolutely love the Microsoft Secure Score. And the reason why is it made it really easy to get started, especially if you're a smaller customer or a partner who doesn't really understand Microsoft security, but you understand security overall, or even if you don't even know security and you don't know what to do. This is your first time. It really simplified how you can take actionable steps to improve your environment. So let's go into it. So the main thing I like is the dashboard. The dashboard is very efficient. It leverages the space very well to understand what you need to do. You can see your total secure score right here. Then you can see how is it broken down and where you're getting the points from. Then if you move to your right, you can see access that you need to review. And then area that's the main critical part is top improvement actions. So let's take a look at some of them. So if you want to enable and block legacy authentication, what is it? It tells me right here. What's the action plan? I got to address that. I haven't done that yet. That's something I need to get done. And then also you can see, all right, at a glance, what category does this fall underneath of? What does it protect against? Password crack and account breach. If you don't know what that is, just research what it is for right here. You don't need to leave. What users will be impacted from this? And then users affected, right? It tells you right there. And then if that wasn't better, how do you install it? Learn more how to turn on security defaults and custom implementations. Take a look at Azure AD conditional access and how to create those policies. If you want to understand more about blocking legacy authentication, read more. So it's everything you need to do to systematically improve your security posture, and they made it into an easy way. You might say, Sylvester, what happened if I'm leveraging a third-party solution? No worries, just mark it as you are resolved through a third party and Microsoft gives you those points. So it's a really cool tool to help you get started with solving some of your security challenges. Another area where I like to take a look at is just how do I compare to organizations like myself? So I'm at 60%. It's not perfect, but at least I know I'm better than a lot of other people. So I still got some ways to go. And if I do want to learn more about different resources, I have some resource guides here. And one thing that I thought was pretty cool is taking a look at the history. So how did I lose 2 points? It told me I need to create a custom active policy to discover suspicious usage patterns, right? I haven't done that. So since I haven't done that, I lost a couple of points, right? So it's a good place just to get started, like I said, to have that conversations. You can take a look at some of the trends that's happening in your environment. You can see a steady incline, the comparison. You can see a lot of the stuff in the environment. So I think this tool is fantastic. What is your thought about it? Do you leverage it in your environment? I would love to know below in the comments. So let me know, how do you use it, if you use it, and did this video convince you to use it?
Now you understand how Secure Score helps improve your security posture of your organization. The next step I need you to do is to continue to watch the videos in my channel, and then also subscribe to the channel and click the bell to stay notified to never miss an episode. Well, until next time, Sly Gittins is out.